Hello Unity Developers, in this video I show you the new feature of the Crystal Generator version 3.5, which includes the Ultra Crystal Generator, and it shows what's its features and how to use it. Now, here we have see a sample scene, and the sample scene contains here this crystalline structure here, and if I click on parts of it, they break apart. Like this, you can see here, they break apart and behave with physics, they become rigid bodies and fly around in the scene. So now I show you how to set it up and what you can do with this. So let's go back to Unity. And the first thing we can see here is the Ultra Crystal Generator. It's the sample scene here, it's newly added. And now I explain the inspector here. The conventional crystal generator uses the large mesh combiner. This one uses the native mesh combiner, which is a new core component. And it requires the Unity job system and the burst package. The burst package can be installed here under Windows Package Manager. And we go here to burst here, we can see here it is installed, and here you can see here is the package which is required. The burst package basically improves the performance of the Ultra Crystal Generator. It would work without the burst package, but it is slower. But we want the full speed, so we have it installed. So now the basic settings. The settings are almost similar to the conventional crystal generator, but it has some additional settings like the initial size distribution, which is a curve determining the start size of newly generated crystals. We have a checkbox to enable or disable growing. If you disable growing, the whole process, generation process is much faster because they don't have to include growing. Also, generation settings, we have the maximum and max iterations. I recommend keeping it very high because the frame rate and the amount of crystals are the least problem. It's basically a combination of the extreme crystal generator and the painter. We can see it now, which I will show you. The next thing is the sector size. The sector size is a very important setting because here we can see a little box. And if we increase the sector size, the box gets larger. And what this does is it creates a region, and every region has a new new mesh piece assigned to it. So if we want to shatter, it's recommended to keep the sector size small. And if we keep it very big, then the whole crystal could be in one single mesh, because now it's possible that the vertex count is larger than 64,000 or somewhat. Now it can be up to 4 billion. So we can now have a region based generation system. So I keep it back to 6. Now here we have buttons. Now what's new is that it also is possible to remove crystals. Now I reset it and we have here the spherical position setting, and if I click here a bit, I let crystals grow, create some more, and now I click here on remove crystals. It does the same with the positioning, but it removes crystals. You can see here, it becomes less and less. I can click times 10, 1 and times 10. Times 10 is obviously faster than times 1. And so it is a new feature which was not possible before. So the next feature is here the Crystal Generator Ultra Painter. When this script is attached to a component holding the Ultra Crystal Generator here, then I can hold Control and paint. I can paint but also use the positioning settings. But now a new feature is now if I hold and click right click, I can remove crystals. The new feature which was highly requested and it was not possible with the Crystal Generator Painter here. It was not possible, but with the Ultra Crystal Generator this is possible. And it is also very very smooth. You can see here. Can remove your crystals and they are removed and now I can if I paint it wrong then I can simply remove it. The Crystal Generator Ultra Painter here has the same settings like the original Crystal Generator paint, but it, with addition that it can remove components. Now another feature is that the crystals can be destroyed. Now if I paint here a bit, paint stuff, paint some like it one. And now we have here another component, which is the Crystal Destroyer here. The Crystal Destroyer has the possibility to destroy and shatter crystals. It is very important if you want to interact with the crystalline structure besides collision detection. So we have here three options. The first option simply removes the crystals. The second option crushes the individual crystals. It removes individual crystals out of the giant sculpture, ignoring the region. And if we set it to shatter region, it will remove it basically converts the whole region into a rigid body. I can show you now the differences here. Here we have collider settings. I recommend to set it as to sphere or box because the convex is very expensive to calculate, but it is the most accurate. But if they are only just fragments, then you can simply set it to sphere because they will vanish anyway. The Crystal Destroyer also uses the mesh piece attachment, which is a component from the large mesh combiner, and it will use its effect to further manipulate individual created fragments. So for this example, I have created a mesh piece attachment which causes the fragments to decay after time, so the fragments will disappear. Now let's check out the. I show you now the remove the three different types if we go to the play mode. If here, now we have here remove. If you click on it simply disappeared. This is the debug mouse mode. So, but you can also call the function which is explained in the documentation by external script. So if you hit the projectile. Hit with a projectile the crystal, then you can call the destroy function and it will shatter the crystal. You also have a whitelist. So you can, if you use it, then you can select which crystal generators are affected. Now, if I click it, it simply disappears. Now, I can change it to shatter individuals. Now, if we click on it, it eats out individual fragments. See here, they are really so crystals which are close together will shatter here. Like here, I eat away stuff here. If the shatter individuals is not that cheap, it's very expensive if a lot of crystals are packed together. So if I recommend to keep the density very low. If the density is high, then I would recommend to use shader region. So now we remove much bigger fragments. Here we can see here, see here the region. If the regions are very dense, you can see the block-like structure. But of course, the region is much faster than destroying individual crystals. Now let's go back and I'll show you another feature, so which may be important, which is the, is it here? It. Okay, now here is it. The crystal pieces, it limits the amount of crystals possible per piece. So if you have basically a game where you can draw crystals, and if you set it, for example, to 3000, then one section can only have 3000 crystals. And if it exceeds this amount, then no crystals will be created in the particular region. So the user cannot put 1 million crystals at one single spot and mess up the whole structure. So I show you how the region look like. If you click here on show generation, then you can see here this is a region. This is another one. You see here the this is a fragment. Can see how the whole the composition of the whole crystalline structure. I hope you like this update. This is a very very new stuff, and thanks to the Unity Burst compiler, which is really amazing. So if you have questions, don't hesitate to ask. And see you next time. Bye.